Hello, everybody, from wherever you're listening or seeing this. Those of you who are at the event, those of you that are watching this on the World Wide Web, I welcome you all, where I want to tell you about what we are embarking on now. We're embarking on a very important mission, and that is to continue the vision of our Rebbe, the Lubavitcher Rebbe, that wanted to encourage Jewish women and girls world over to light Shabbos candles. And I think, you know, there's been this campaign that's going on for 41 years, and we have been trying to get women and girls world over to light Shabbos candles. And we were very successful in reaching out to even young children. And what's very interesting is that at one point, after we have been distributing candlesticks to children all over the world, and in schools here all over New York, one day in 1977, I received a packet of compositions and essays that were written by very young girls that go to Hebrew school. And the teacher sent it to me because she was very proud of what the children wrote. And they wrote very beautiful things, young girls, about how happy and how proud they are about lighting Shabbos candles. When I sent these compositions to the Rebbe that he should have the enjoyment from it, he directed me to make a book. And the Rebbe even instructed us that if we have entries from very young girls, that we should print it in their own handwriting so people should believe that they actually wrote it themselves and it's not something that we made up. So here I have something to show you how a little girl of 6 years old that went to a public school wrote in her own handwriting how happy she is and how proud she is to light Shabbat candles. We have children of different backgrounds from different cities, different countries, different places, different ages, and all of them wrote the most beautiful things. Of course, we gave prizes according to what the Rebbe told us to, and the children were very happy and very proud. And we sold these books, and they were actually grabbed by all the bookstores, and people enjoyed having it. And we made another contest, and we actually got children from very many different places. And we thought that all we're doing is making a contest and giving prizes just to get the children excited. But lo and behold, one day the Rebbe says he's waiting for the second book, which I never thought we were going to do. And we had to do something different because it couldn't be exactly the same. So we went ahead with somebody who designed for us a book. And this is the second book of A Candle of My Own. And as you see, this is photographs. Instead of artwork, it's photographs. And we dispatched a photographer to Camp Emuna because the last week of camp, interestingly, one beautiful picture he took of who we know today as the Hamadina Labor, who was then the Hamadina Wasserman. This is a picture of her when she was about 4 or 5 years old. So we see that the Rebbe's vision of having this book published so that people can see how children actually love lighting Shabbat candles and how it has an effect on them. We have stories of how many children that wrote articles here, compositions here, actually it changed their life. There's a girl that we are in touch with today, till today. She wrote this all the years back in 1977. When she found this book in a Chabad house where she had already become religious and Shabbos observant, she couldn't go home to her dormitory because she would have to travel. She found the book in the library of the Chabad house and she said, oh, look at this. I wrote this when I was a little girl. And because they printed it, I was so careful to light my candle every Friday night because they wrote in the book that I light every Friday night. And this is what actually brought me to become Shabbos observant. We see that the Rebbe had a vision that this is going to help inspire girls to continue to keep Shabbat and to light Shabbat candles. It's going to inspire other mothers to get their children to want to light. It's going to inspire teachers and educators, and it's going to inspire so many people to get other people to light Shabbos candles. So that was the Rebbe's vision, and that's what we are trying to perpetuate now. And I want to thank this organization that Mrs. Labor is leading, that's called Jewish Girls Unite. There's going to be a third book because we're launching this campaign, this contest now. And this is going to be worldwide because all the global message that's going around about this contest, we hope to get entries from all over the world. The book is going to be something magnificent. And this is going to be, if it's going to be called One More Light, because that's what we're calling this campaign, or it's going to be called A Candle of My Own, I don't know yet. It's all up to you and what you people that are watching this and listening are going to come up with. And we know that every person that lights one more candle will get another person to light one more candle, that will get another person to light one more candle, which will ultimately bring us to the time when we will see the redemption of the Jewish people through the coming of Mashiach.